Dear learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. I'm Dr. Suparna Jain from Daulat Ram College, University of Delhi. I'll be discussing lesson 9 of early childhood care and education in this video, pertaining to stages of child development, especially for 3 to 6 year old children and 6 to 8 year old children. Before we start with the video, let me talk about the learning outcomes of this session today. So if you go thoroughly through this video, you'll be able to explain the developmental characteristics and needs of 3 to 6 year old children. You'll also be able to explain the developmental characteristics and needs of 6 to 8 year old children. Plus, you'll be able to describe the pattern of physical and socio-emotional development among these two age brackets. So before I move on to domains of development, let me first give you an introduction about these two age brackets. So the first one is the 3 to 6 year old children. As we know that during this time, they are ready to go for preschool. So this is also called preschool stage. And this is the time when they start achieving muscle development and coordination. Also, they build abilities to think and speak. Now is the time when they learn and they gain the power of observation, memory, and verbal skills. And these abilities improve rapidly. They are also learning essential life skills such as dressing themselves up, eating by themselves, because now is the time that they are growing independent. They have to start going to the school and they are ready to get separated from their parents when they are going to the preschool. Now, moving to the second bracket, that is 6 to 8 year old children, this is also known as early primary stage. And at this time, there's a rapid development of physical, social, and cognitive skills. At this time, there is also a high development of confidence. This is the time they attain independence and industry. And this is also the time when they regularly contact the larger world outside. So friendships become very important for them. So now it's not only the parents who are helping them socialize, but it is also the external world when they go to the school, when they meet their peers, when they meet their teachers. So they learn a lot about the social world and friendships become very important. So here today in this video, we'll be discussing domains of development. There are 4 domains of development when we talk about children. They are physical development, socio-emotional development, cognitive development, and language development. So let's begin with physical development. So what I'll do is I'll go domain-wise and I'll be talking about the 2 age brackets simultaneously while I'll be going in each domain. So let's begin with physical development, the domain of physical development. Now let's begin with the age bracket of 3 to 6 years. So at this time, muscular and skeletal growth progresses and the children become very, very strong, physically strong. So very importantly, one thing, as you can see here in the flow chart, the first thing that they develop in their physical abilities is gross motor abilities. So their gross motor skills are increasing. How? By indulging into activities such as running, jumping, throwing, kicking. They are now able to catch a bounced ball. They are now able to paddle their tricycle. And as they are able to do all of this, it's also the fine motor activities and fine motor skills that they are polishing now. So how is that happening? They are able to draw geometrical figures like circles and squares. They are now able to use blunt tip scissors that are meant specially for children. They are able to dress themselves without supervision. They are able to manage spoon and fork neatly while they are eating. So as you can see in the flow chart, I have stated over here that initially there are gross motor abilities that develop, then comes in the fine motor abilities. And then as the children progress towards the age of 6 to 8, they start gaining weight faster. And thus what happens is that their large muscles, especially of arms and legs, they start developing very fast. And this is the time when children engage in a lot of physical play. As a result, they gain greater control over body movements. So as we are talking about gross motor skills and fine motor skills, you can see here in this very cute picture that's given here, where the children of this age group, 3 to 6 especially, they start standing with the help of the wall. They take support of the wall and they start scribbling over the wall. You must have observed that around you. So what happens is that here, when they're able to stand with the support of the wall, this shows you their gross motor skills that are developing. And when they are scribbling on the wall, it shows you that their fine motor skills are developing as they're using sketch pens or colors. So this is a proof that they are physically developing well. So all in all, the domain of physical development is very important for the children at this age. And for that, it's very important that we provide them with the resource of playing and we provide them with toys. And it becomes very important for physically developing them. So this is about physical development. Let's move on to the second domain of development at this age, which is very important. That is socio-emotional development. Now, beginning with the age group 3 to 6 years old, the first thing that's very interesting about them is they start describing themselves. That is who they are. So although when they're describing themselves, they're focusing on the observable, concrete, and physical characteristics. That is, for example, they'll talk about who they are, what their name is, what toys they like, what toys they possess, then who their family members are. So they're talking in very concrete terms about when they're describing themselves. But at the same time, their gender identity is also developing. So they start dressing according to their gender. They start selecting their toys according to their gender. So all in all, what is happening over here is that there is an emerging concept of self that is happening. As you can see in the flowchart that has been developed for you. So in this flowchart, when I talk about the preschool stage children, you can see the first thing that I've stated over here is that they are now describing themselves and there is an emerging sense of self-concept. Second is that now they are also able to verbalize emotions. Now that means that they can talk about their own feelings and emotions now. In their vocabulary, there are words that are pertaining to emotions. But at the same time, they are still not able to understand complex emotions. So as a result of which, what happens is they still need support, they still need assistance from their parents when they are experiencing complex emotions such as rage, or frustration or shame, right? Okay, third thing that's happening here in this age group is that they're learning social skills needed to play and to work with other children. So they're socializing a lot and they're learning to socialize and becoming a part of the group. And when we talk about the six to eight year old children, as you can see in the flow chart over here, you can see here that the first thing that I've stated here for early primary stages that they form broader self-concept. That means now they're not only focusing on their physical characteristics, but now they're also talking about internal characteristics. So when you ask a child of this age that who you are and explain yourself or tell about yourself, so they will not only talk about their name and family members, but they will also talk about that I'm a good girl, I'm a bad girl, or I'm a good boy, and things like that. So what is happening? They're recognizing their strengths and weaknesses, especially with regard to social, academic, and athletic skills. Plus, now they are able to understand more complex emotions such as confusion and excitement. And also, they are developing a sense of right and wrong, which helps them sustain a peer group interaction and maintain friendship for a long period of time. So, as you can see, when we compare the two age brackets over here, one is primary school stage and the other is early primary stage. As I told you initially, that primary school stage is 3 to 6 year olds and early primary stage is 6 to 8 year olds. So we can see here that there is a constant development in the socio-emotional domain. From self-concept being emerging, their self-concept becomes broader. From verbalizing emotions, they are now able to understand complex emotions. From initiating play, now they are able to maintain friendships. So you can see that children of this age, they are constantly developing in terms of socio and emotional aspects, which is very important, for which we need to support them. So now after this session, you can now understand that how important physical development and socio-emotional development is there for the children. And that is why it's very important for the parents and the adults around them and even their elder siblings to provide them with opportunities which stimulate them to become physically active, which stimulate them to become emotionally strong. So it's very important that we help children to attain these milestones of development. Thank you.